Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronic. In this video, we will learn common emitter configuration of BJT. Whenever the BJT is used as an amplifier, most of the times it is used in common emitter configuration. Like here, in this single stage common emitter audio amplifier circuit, the input signal is applied at the base terminal of the BJT. And these biasing resistors R1, R2 and RE are providing biasing to the transistor. The biasing is very important in an amplifier design as it establishes the correct operating conditions of the transistor to amplify the input signal. Let's construct a common emitter amplifier. In this configuration, the input signal is applied between emitter and base terminal, and the output is measured between emitter and collector terminal. That means in this configuration, emitter terminal is common for both input and output. As we know that in a BJT, there are two depletion regions. So to use BJT as an amplifier, we must keep the base emitter junction forward biased while the base collector junction must be reverse biased. This is called biasing of a BJT. Biasing sets transistor in optimal operating condition. So this is how we must apply biasing in a common emitter configuration of a NPN transistor. VC must be greater than VB and VB must be greater than VE. Here, emitter terminal is common for the biasing. The schematical representation of common emitter amplifier is like this. Here, input is applied between base and emitter, and output is measured between collector and emitter terminal. So, the voltage VBE is known as the input voltage, and the voltage VCE is known as the output voltage. And if we see the direction of the current, then they will be like this. Here, IB is the base current, that is input current. And IC is the collector current, that will be the output current. Hence, VBE and IB are the input characteristics and VCE and IC are the output characteristics of this circuit. Now, if we apply a sine wave input between base and emitter terminal, then we will get amplified output between the collector and emitter terminal. Here, to understand this circuit clearly, we need to understand the input and output characteristics of this circuit. The input characteristics defines the relationship between the base current IB and the voltage VBE. Here we can see the different IB versus VBE curves for the different values of VCE. If we observe these curves, they are very similar to the PN junction forward characteristic curves. It is because the forward biasing of the base emitter junction or the input side is forward biased. And one more thing, if you observe over here, as we increase the value of VCE, then this base current IB is reducing. Let's see the reason behind it. Now let's consider that the voltage between collector and emitter is VCE and the voltage between base and emitter is VBE and the voltage between base and collector is VBC. Now here this voltage VCE can be given as voltage VBE plus voltage VBC. Now if we keep this voltage VBE fixed and increase the value of VCE, then the voltage VBC will also increase. Here as the value of VBC increases, then the reverse bias between base and collector terminal will also increase. This reverse bias will increase the width of the depletion region between base and collector junction. Here as we increase the value of VBC, then this depletion region's width will increase. So due to this, the width of the base region will decrease. And due to this reduced base width, there are very less number of holes available in this P region. Hence, lesser number of electrons from emitter will recombine with the holes in the base region. And most of the electrons will get collected at the collector region. Because of this type of behavior, the base current IB will reduce. Hence, we can say that as the value of VCE increases, this base current IB will reduce. This is what we have observed in input characteristic curve. As the value of VCE increases, the base current IB is reducing. That's why we are getting this type of curves. Alright, now let's discuss the output characteristics. They were VCE and IC. The output characteristic curve shows the relationship between the collector current IC and the voltage VCE. So, here are the different IC versus VCE curves for the different values of the base current IB. Here we can divide these curves into three regions. First one is the active region. The second one is the saturation region. And the third one is the cutoff region. We will discuss all these three regions one by one. First one, active region. In this region, as the base current IB increases, this collector current IC also increases. One more thing is that here, as the value of PCE increases, this collector current IC also increases. This means here the collector curves are not totally horizontal. It is because, as we discussed earlier, VCE equals to VBE plus VBC. If we keep VBE fixed and as we increase the VCE, the VBC will increase. This means reverse bias between base and collector increases. This creates a thick depletion region in base and collector junction. This depletion region keep on increasing as the reverse bias VBC increases. Due to this, the effective base width will reduce. Because of this reduced base width, the probability of recombination in base region will also reduces. And due to this, most of the electrons will get collected at the collector region. Due to this type of behavior, we can say that as the value of PCE increases, this collector current IC also increases. As we know that whenever BJT is used as an amplifier, then it is used in active region. In active region, the base current IB gets amplified by the factor of beta. That means if IB is the input current, then the output current IC equals to beta times IB. So this beta is known as the DC current gain of the common emitter configuration. Now, if we talk about the AC current gain, then this beta AC can be given as delta IC divided by delta IB. That means change in the collector current divided by the change in the base current. Usually, the value of beta AC and beta DC are not same, but as their values are very close to each other, they often used interchangeably. We can find beta values in data sheet of the transistor. Now let's discuss the second region of operation. That is the saturation region. Here, if you observe in this curve, as the value of PCE reduces and gets closer to zero, at that time, this collector current IC increases very sharply. It is because whenever the VCE is reducing to zero, at that time, this base and collector junction becomes forward biased. Now, if you observe over here, both the junctions of the BJT are forward biased. That means base to emitter and base to collector junctions are forward biased. In this condition, the BJT operates in saturation region. This is what we can see here in this curve. Now, the third region of operation, that is cutoff region. Whenever base current IB equals to 0, then the BJT operates in this cutoff region. But if you notice over here, the collector current IC is not 0. Or we can say that the value of collector current is relatively large. This collector current exists because of the leakage current IC BO. Here, by seeing this graph, we can say that whenever IB equals to 0, at that time, the leakage current IC BO is more. Let's understand this concept clearly. In case of common base configuration, the collector current IC equals to alpha times IE plus IC BO, where IC BO is the reverse saturation current. Now here we also know that emitter current IE equals to IC plus IB. So we will insert IE value in this equation. That means we can say that collector current IC equals to alpha times IC plus IB plus IC BO. So IC equals to alpha times IC plus alpha times IB plus IC BO. Now we will take alpha IC to left hand side. So IC minus alpha IC equals to alpha times IB plus IC BO. Now we take IC as common. So IC times 1 minus alpha equals to alpha IB plus IC BO. Now if we take this 1 minus alpha on right hand side, then IC equals to alpha divided by 1 minus alpha into IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha IC BO. Now we know that this alpha by 1 minus alpha is equals to beta. So we can say that this collector current IC equals to beta into IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha IC BO. Now whenever this base current IB is 0, at that time this beta into IB becomes 0. So the collector current current IC equals to 1 by 1 minus alpha into ICBO. Now, typically the value of alpha is very close to unity and typically it varies from 0.95 to 0.99. So, in this equation, alpha value is very close to 1. So, 1 minus alpha value is very small. Hence, 1 by 1 minus alpha value is very big. Now, we try to solve this equation alpha by 1 minus alpha equals to beta by adding plus 1 on both sides. So, alpha by 1 minus alpha plus 1 equals to beta plus 1. Now, here 1 minus alpha is our LCM. So, on top it comes as alpha plus 1 minus alpha. That equals to beta plus 1. Here we can strike out this plus alpha and minus alpha. Hence, beta plus 1 equals to 1 by 1 minus alpha. Now, here IC equals to, we can write 1 by 1 minus alpha as beta plus 1. So, IC equals to beta plus 1 into ICBO. So, this will be the value of the leakage current whenever the base current IB equals to 0. And it is defined as current ICEO. That means whenever the base terminal is open or the base current IB is 0, then ICEO is the leakage current which is flowing through the collector terminal to emitter terminal. So the value of ICEO can be given as beta plus 1 into ICBO. If we observe this equation, we can say that in common emitter configuration, this leakage current ICBO gets amplified by the factor of beta plus 1. So let's say for one BJT, if beta is 99 and the value of ICBO is 1 microampere, in that case, the leakage current ICEO is equals to 100 microampere. And that is why in output characteristic curve, in the cutoff region, we can see there is a large leakage current. Now, as we discussed earlier, during active region of operation, this input current IB gets amplified by the factor of beta. And beta is known as the current gain of this configuration, where beta equals to ratio of change in collector current delta IC to change in base current delta IB at a constant collector emitter voltage VCE. The typical value of beta in common emitter configuration is in the range between 50 to 500. So we will get high current gain in this configuration. And whenever we connect the load resistance or collector resistance RC in this configuration, we can obtain the voltage gain. A higher RC value gives higher voltage gain, but excessive RC value leads to saturation. The voltage gain in common emitter configuration approximated as the product of current gain beta and the ratio of output resistance of the collector RC to the input resistance of the base circuit RB. In short, AV equals to beta times RC by RB. The typical value is around 550. Next one, power gain of common emitter amplifier. It is nothing but product of current gain beta and the voltage gain AV of the amplifier circuit. The typical value is around 1000. So we get very high power gain in this configuration. Now as we know that P equals to V into I. That equals to V into current I can be written as V by R. That makes P equals to V square by R. So here we can write this power gain as voltage gain AV square divided by resistance gain RG. Simply PG equals to AV square by RG. Now here resistance gain RG is defined as the ratio of output impedance ZO to the input impedance ZI. The output impedance of common emitter configuration is just equals to the collector resistor in parallel with the load resistor. RC parallel to RL if connected. Otherwise it's just RC. Generally it is in the range of 40 kilo ohms to 50 kilo ohms. So this configuration have high output impedance because if you observe the output characteristic curve, these collector curves are not perfectly horizontal. Similarly, let's see the input impedance. The formula is Zin equals to Req parallel to beta times capital Re plus small Re, where Req is the equivalent resistance of the biasing network to ground and capital Re is emitter resistance and small Re is internal signal resistance of the emitter layer. The typical range is 100 ohms to 6 kilo ohm. So this circuit offers low input impedance. This can be found by finding the slope of this input characteristic curve. as we know that R equals to V by I. So here input resistance Ri equals to change in input voltage delta VBE divided by change in input current delta IB. One more thing is that the output voltage waveform is 180 degrees out of phase with the input voltage waveform. It means the output signal is inverted compared to the input. So these are the basic properties of the common emitter configuration. And we will discuss these properties thoroughly in upcoming video. If we talk about the applications of common emitter configuration, it is widely used in audio amplifier circuits for signal amplification. This circuit also widely used in radio frequency circuit. That's all about common emitter configuration of BJT. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.